Inside this blister pack, I have a Vivitar keychain camera. Date on the package says 2008. Says it's a video camera, says it's a webcam. Well, we'll see how good it is at those things. That's coming up on Thrifty AV. At the risk of disappointing the knife crowd out there, I'm gonna open this blister pack up with Harbor Freight kitchen shears. And yes, that price tag is right. I slapped down $4.99 plus tax for the privilege of trying out this device. I'm gonna read some of that actually. Wonder if this battery's gonna work. It had a CVS sticker on here, but it didn't have a CVS price tag, so no telling what this originally cost. And this fell out of the package. This is USB type A, and I don't know what this little USB connection is called, but this is obviously the side I'm gonna put into the camera. Ooh, it includes a little case for it. And you can put that case on a strap. There's a disc in here. Literature, 3-in-1, still camera, video camera, web camera. You can shoot 243 photos, 16 megabytes of memory. And here they're going over the accessories in it. Made in China. 13 years sitting in packaging and it still reads good. Now it's not at the top of the good, but it's good. Well, it beeped at me. All right, I have not read any instructions yet. I'm gonna try to just snap a few pictures here. It does make a little beep when it takes the picture. I'm gonna hold my mic closer to it so you can hear. I wonder if the mic got in the frame. So now it says 15 in here in the where the mode is. I'm gonna hit this button though. OF, I'm gonna assume that's off maybe. I read a little bit about modes. Now I'm gonna see if I understood what I read. I'm gonna hit this button and it's showing me, it showed HR and now it's showing me 13. So HR means it's taking high resolution photos, which is what I want. Don't know how to change it to low resolution. Guess, okay, OFCEAHICLCRCP continuous. AI's the AVI, that's video. There's a lot of things controlled by this one button. I had some issues with the modes and the instructions not quite matching what I'm seeing here, but I do know that AI is video mode. And this is something in particular I want to check out. Now that 10 is basically how many memory units, how many uncompressed photos you can fit. Now with this AVI mode, it's going to compress, but those kind of represent how much memory's left. And to do a video, you actually have to hold the button down and keep the button push down for the duration of the video you are shooting. They say I should install the software before hooking this up to a computer, but I'm gonna live dangerously and hook this up to a computer right now. I know there's unboxings. Does anyone do untwistings? Time to see if this will be recognized. Setting up a device. Still hasn't told me the device is ready. Okay, device manager detected dual mode digital camera, but it says the drivers for this device are not installed. There are no compatible drivers. To find a driver, click update driver. Let's try. Windows cannot find drivers for your device. Search for updated drivers on Windows Update. I doubt this is successful. This software doesn't say anything about what it's compatible with, which I find a little bit weird. I even read through all this, nothing about which operating system I should use this software on. So I'm gonna try something I've been avoiding and see if anything on this CD will work. I'm gonna go with the X64 driver. Installing drivers. Windows has successfully updated your device. Well, the driver installed, but I still couldn't use any of my built-in apps. See what I find under drivers. So Photo Impressions is the software I'm installing here. I'm glad that this isn't my normal daily driver computer, because I install some sketchy stuff on here sometimes. Let's check this My Camera thing out. Camera contains 12 image files. Do you want to download them? Yes. Okay, so photo impressions is just some bloatware. What I really needed was this My Camera app in order to get the photos off of the camera. I got the driver to install on the Windows 10 machine, but I could never get those files off of that software. So I'm gonna try Windows 98 next. Now this My Camera showed up here when I did the driver installation. Let's plug the camera in. Okay, I'm going into Device Manager. I'm gonna reinstall driver. All right, so failure on Windows 98. So far, I had trouble pulling images off the camera with Windows 10. I couldn't load a driver with Windows 98. So now I'm gonna try to use Windows XP. It found the hardware. Let's install the drivers again. I'm gonna hook the camera up. And now it says the hardware is installed and ready to use. And it is transferring the files. File, save all items. Okay, I'm gonna stick it in the F drive Vivitar. Okay, here it is PC camera mode. So now it is acting as a webcam and it is pointing up at my ceiling fan. Now what I need to do is I need to be able to clear this camera's memory so that I can store more stuff on it. In the manual it talked about a clear all mode, but I couldn't find it in here. So what I ended up doing is just removing and reinstalling the battery, and that cleared everything. And while I was doing that, I found something that I didn't know about. This thing has a viewfinder. Not much of one. Exploring my Windows 10 machine a little better, I was able to find the files off of the Vivitar, but they weren't saved where I wanted to save them. They're under App Data Local Virtual Store. At high resolution, the dimensions on these image files were 352 by 288 pixels with a bit depth of 24. On the video file, I had the same frame width and height, but the frame rate was only 5 frames per second. Let's take a look at some of these pictures and videos. Here's that shot of the battery tester, and I got lucky on the framing on this selfie. I wasn't sure how close to get to my storage shed, so I got a few different variations. This one just shows the door of the shed. Here's my backyard. While I was messing with the camera settings, I guess I took this picture. All the photos skew to the right compared to the viewfinder. This was supposed to be my herb garden, not my porch. There is no microphone on this camera, so there is no audio on the video. And 5 frames per second makes for a pretty choppy video. Let's compare this video to something I shot with a flip phone from about that same era.
Okay, I'm shooting on the Samsung phone right now, and the Vivitar is magically back in its blister pack because I shot this video out of sequence.
I know it's sad to say, but the Vivitar Keychain camera will not be making it onto my keychain. Even at the highest resolution, it was pretty low resolution. 5 frames per second is way too choppy for effective video. There's not enough internal memory to shoot a whole lot of photos or a very long video. I just got a few seconds of 5 frame per second video, and it doesn't play nice with Windows 10. Also, a flip phone from that same era did a better job with the video. So it's really not that surprising. The device never sold. It just stayed on the store shelf until it was given away to Goodwill. I wasted my $5 so you don't have to. If you enjoyed this video, smash that like button. Thank you to my patrons for supporting this channel. And remember, stay thrifty, everyone.